Good evening everyone, and a very warm welcome to our Newsreel 18. The weather this year has been quite unique, in that around Easter we were in the depths of winter with snow drifts all over the country. But not long after, the heat of the sun was cracking the flags, which of course was the beginning of a wonderful summer, so no complaints there. Most of Burnley's outdoor events were bathed in sunshine. A fine day made the Cliviger Duck Race even more enjoyable for families. May Day celebrations both at Higham and Towneley were bathed in sunshine. Our new mayors, that is Burnley and Pendle, each had a very busy calendar. But this year, as last year, we start with a couple of events at the end of 2017, and firstly, Burnley's Festival of Light.
By mid-October 2017, preparations for Burnley's first Light Festival were well underway. Workshops were held at several locations in the town centre.
I'm Lisa, I'm a textile artist, I'm based in Burnley and I'm part of the Creative Alliance, and a few of us have got together and we are now the Lantern Squad, and we are producing lanterns for the Christmas Light Switch On and the Lantern Parade for Burnley Town Centre.
Right, today we're running workshops in the library to make lanterns for the Burnley Winter Lights Festival, which is going to be on the 18th and 19th of November. It's the Winter Light Parade is the precursor to switching the Christmas lights on.
Everybody, all the jellyfishes up!
And then it was all systems go on the big day.
I'm very excited.
Are you now? And you're going to enjoy walking through the town carrying that? Have you helped to make it? Oh.
It's a jellyfish. The stick's too long.
So after 3 weeks of working on all of these amazing lanterns, we are finally ready for the parade, and the samba band's turned up, and it's absolutely amazing.
How do you think it's gone?
I think it's gone really well. I'm so pleased with the turnout. I'm so pleased with everybody's creations. And I've just looked out into the crowd and seen smiles on everybody's faces, so I can't say fairer than that.
Guests arriving at the show were met by Burnley's Mayor and Mayoress.
Welcome to Burnley College.
Thank you.
Mr. Mayor, Madam Mayoress.
Thank you.
We hope you enjoy the evening. Can you tell us what the session is all about tonight?
Certainly. It's a fashion show organised by the Mayoress's committee. And over to you, Madam Mayoress, because you know exactly what you're doing.
Okay, so what we are trying to do is fundraise for local communities and charities within the Burnley area, those who have no PR or marketing departments, and it's basically the unsung heroes that we are trying to raise money for. So it could be anything. It could be homeless, elderly, animals, children, whoever needs any financial help and assistance, that's what we're there to help.
After an excellent buffet and entertainment by the performing arts students from Burnley College, it was time for the show to begin.
I'm delighted that you're all here tonight and you've turned out for an extremely good cause. Enjoy! And then if you're looking for some great stocking fillers, how about some of our gloves? Now these are just the faux fur great suede. We've got these loads of colours. Green this year has been big, so if it's a little bit too much with all the khakis, we've gone with the soft greens. This gorgeous hat, detachable pom, so you can take them to the tans, to the blacks, to this gorgeous green. Some more bags, the saddle bag. Comes with all those gorgeous twinkles, top end of our price point, around the 17. Gloves come in just £7.99. We've also got the Emma in that fabulous Burberry looking scarf with the fringing. Those were 15. Now if you want to really push the boat out, it's like a big thank you. That was absolutely wonderful. Thank you, Maureen.
Thank you, ladies. Thank you very much indeed for your support, and hopefully we'll see you again soon. Have a lovely Christmas. Thank you.
Spring this year seemed to take a long time to get started. Easter was not a dry one by any means, but the folk of Pendle were not deterred. Colne was in festive mood with Easter stalls and many attractions and activities.
So, today in Colne we're doing Easter in Colne, so we've got lots of kids' activities, free donkey rides, fun fair, colouring competitions, and it's just to help with the town and keep things going.
I wonder if our MP is interested in joining Burnley Film Makers.
And this is the Colne Easter event. It's a wonderful event, despite the weather. Lots of people have turned up here. We've got events in St Bartholomew's. We've got an Easter egg competition going on in the library.
Free donkey rides.
There's all sorts of things going on. Lots of things going on in here. Lots of things going on down the road in Nelson, up in Barnoldswick. Lots going on in Pendle today.
We then had a word with the Mayor of Pendle.
We're glad to come to Colne to support the Easter day in Colne. They've put a lot of effort in. We've seen the brass band, we've seen the Morris dancers. We wish the weather was a bit warmer, but we can't do anything about that. So what we're doing is looking around all the shops now to take in all them in to make sure that we're not missing anything in Colne, because there's a lot going on today.
I asked the mayoress what she had enjoyed most about her 12 months in office.
Well, the thing I was dreading most was the fundraising. And actually, it's been one of the things I've most enjoyed. It started off just supporting the Friends of Pendle's Park and celebrating the work they were doing and getting them a bit of money instead of them always having to ask for money.
On Easter Saturday, we visited Shaw's Hay Farm, the home of Happer, the Pony and Horse Rescue Centre. And over the Easter weekend, the arena at Happer was filled with what can only be described as a complete day out for the family, with all number of items for sale and displayed that you would not find in the High Street, along with entertainment for the kids and for mums and dads.
Well, here we've got Crafty Vintage and the Happer have joined forces to put on this event to raise awareness of Happer and also to bring together kind of makers and creators and artists, photographers, who have all brought all the wares to sell under one big arena, really. And then we've got Brian the Magician on, which is doing magic shows all throughout the day, which is great. We've got singers on and acoustic sets. So it's a big kind of social gathering of all sorts of different things that are going on, all under one roof. A great family day out.
Again, another great day out for the whole family. This looks like the depth of winter. But no, this was the beginning of spring this year, when the country was hit by
so-called beast from the east. Some were stranded in their vehicles for hours.
Good evening. Southwest England and South Wales are on red alert tonight as two weather fronts collide, bringing with them heavy blizzards, heavy snow and ice. The freezing Siberian weather that's battered much of the UK has joined forces with Storm Emma.
Quite a shock to wake up to this when we were quietly waiting for some nice weather to start after a grim winter. Ever see summer again? Icicles get everywhere.
Saturday, April 7th, and it was Cars and Coffee Day at the home of Burnley Football Club, Turf Moor. The weather was less than kind, and most people were inside for the coffee, rather than outside for the cars. We asked organiser Chris Walker about the event.
Right, Chris, can you tell me a little bit about what's happening today?
Okay, today is organised by Pendle Power Fest, which is a group of volunteers based in the Pendle area, but we live in Barrowford most. Our office is in Barrowford. We run a major event at the end of May every year that's a family motor show that's always for a different charity each year. Then we've expanded that into doing these cars and coffee events, which are a free event. People just turn up, bring whatever they're into, bikes, trucks, cars, whatever, and then we try and add a bit of added value to that.
Is this your
yes,
piece?
It's my Ford Ranger.
Yeah, and how did it come about?
I used to have a Hilux and I had a little bit of artwork done on it, basically soldiers silhouetted on a sunset. It got a bit too old, so I upgraded to this about 5 years ago, and it's just progressed from there bit by bit. Just keep adding some every time I get a little bit of extra cash.
And here at Cars and Coffee this weekend, we have a fantastic Lotus Elise. It's made famous by the Formula One racing team, Colin Chapman, who went on to win many Formula One titles. This year is actually one of his famous racing drivers, Centenary, the famous Jim Clark, Formula One world champion, who went on to win many races in the Formula One title. And here we have this fantastic car, which has turned up at Cars and Coffee in its lovely burnt orange colour. It's wonderful to see this sort of thing turn up here today, even in these rainy conditions. But are we bothered? We're not bothered. The RAF cadets did their bit to celebrate the Royal Air Force Centenary. It was formed on the 1st of April 1918 and is the oldest independent air force in the world. On April the 8th this year, around 120 cadets and staff from Accrington, Burnley, Blackburn and Pendle came together for a spectacular march from the William Thompson car park to St Peter's Church in Burnley.
Parade! For the centre in column of route! Quick! March!
The North Region Air Training Corps Band provided the sterling marching sound. Many of our local mayors took the salute as the parade marched past. This is a chain of mayors, is it? I understand. Morning, sir.
Good morning.
David, Mum, carry on, sir. You're doing a good job. The dignitaries were soon settled into their seats as the service began. As part of the service, organiser Squadron Leader Alan Walker, RAF retired, gave a brief history on the RAF.
By the withdrawal from overseas areas of influence.
After the service, it was time for photographs, and of course light refreshments.
You often get events like this where you turn up, the event happens and you go away, but afterwards you think, gosh, that would have taken some organising. Well, this is one of them, and this, I thought it was very well put together. It reflected what they were trying to do about the 100 years since the RAF was formed, so well done to them all.
This is a truly great ceremony. It's really good to see Burnley Squadron, 352 Squadron, here today. They do an excellent job. We support the Mayor throughout the year and all the other services, and it's good to be able to come and help them a bit the other way around.
A wonderful acknowledgement to our Royal Air Force.
April the 10th, and our Mayor of Pendle hosted Commonwealth Day celebrations at the Town Hall.
Yes, well, we're very proud today to host this Commonwealth celebration event. We've got Lord Shuttleworth and Lady Shuttleworth coming. We've got the High Sheriff of Lancashire coming, and quite a few other distinguished guests.
One invited guest was the very proud son of Subedar Major Nawab Khan Chandre of the 23rd Mountain Regiment, Royal Indian Artillery. He served in two world wars, plus active service on the treacherous northwest frontier.
Well, I am very much proud of my father. He served in the British Army for 33 years in the Royal Indian Artillery. And he has got decorations there. I think you got full report on that form there. And how he went, how he served.
The new High Sheriff of Lancashire being introduced to the Mayor. Lord Shuttleworth arriving. We managed a quick word with Lord Shuttleworth.
Well, isn't it wonderful that we're celebrating something that is so British, so Lancashire, yet encompasses about a third of the world's population? You know, we're really having a wonderful Commonwealth celebration this week, next week, in Lancashire, and I'm really amazed by how people have taken it to their hearts in this county.
Also, Pendle MP Andrew Stevenson spoke to us.
Well, it's wonderful that Pendle Council is celebrating the Commonwealth. We've got the Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting taking place in London shortly. And I think it's really important that across the UK we celebrate the importance of the Commonwealth to the United Kingdom and to the world and what it stands for.
After recently being appointed High Sheriff of Lancashire, Mr. Tony Attard was also pleased to express his feelings to us with regard to the Commonwealth.
As High Sheriff of Lancashire, it's a great pleasure to be here today to commemorate the Commonwealth, because of course the Commonwealth is very important both politically and economically to Great Britain. The Queen, as being head of the Commonwealth, has been absolutely phenomenal in growing the Commonwealth and instrumental in portraying all that's good about the Commonwealth. And that interaction can only result in good things for the future, for now and for the future.
After a somewhat wet walk to Christchurch, a special service was arranged, followed by some wonderful refreshments. Outside may have been wet and windy, but inside the warmth was evident as this wonderful day came to a close.
May Bank Holiday Weekend at Higham. The weather was glorious for this three-day event.
Hi, Keith. Hello, dear.
Which takes in the traditional Higham Craft Fair, where the works of local artists and the many crafts are on display. Outside in the sunshine, there are many attractions and events, from canine obedience and agility that's how it should be done. Okay, let's not have any showing off now. to birds of prey. But the highlight has to be the children of St John's School, with their display of traditional maypole dancing.
You did this last year, apparently, yes?
I did, yeah, this is the second year.
Last year was the first time for what, 60 years I believe?
60 years I believe. It's the original maypole. It was put away apparently 60 years ago under the church, I believe. And now we've got it back out again. We've done a bit of work on it and it's back up and running with the children of high school.
May 2018, at a football club not very far away. Star Wars Family Fun Day took place at Turf Moor on the May Day bank holiday, drawing fans of the film series from across the northwest. Many of the film's characters were busy welcoming visitors and taking part in the odd selfie. For collectors, there were lots of stands available, offering everything from comics, figures and models, to buying your own favourite character's suit. A number of the Star Wars actors were present for autograph collectors, and you could get your photograph taken with several of the characters. One of the Star Wars model makers showed how some of the film models were made. The event helped raise money for East Lancashire Hospice. By the afternoon it was sweltering and even Chewie had to sit down for a bit. Family Fun Day had been a really good day out, and it was time to make our farewells. How many Imperial Stormtroopers can you fit in a lift? So, from a small corner of the galaxy, until next time, may the Force be with you.
St John the Divine Church at Home Chapel, set in the picturesque Cliviger Gorge, organised a duck race on May Day to raise church funds. Sponsors of the event are displayed on the main road and it took place at the Park Road play area. Stalls were available.
The ducks now! They're going in about 5 minutes.
At the other end.
Last minute sales are added. Good turnout along the route. The leaders are coming.
How many are there?
The finish line team getting ready. Back out on the course. The sweep team make sure no ducks are left behind.
Get away! Walk away!
Over £2,000 was raised for the upkeep of the church and the event was enjoyed by all.
Burnley's May Day Festival is one of the very few in the country that has been held every year since the May Day Bank Holiday was established in 1978. On a day like today, Towneley is the perfect setting. Organisers started very early, setting things up. Here, the main stage getting plugged in.
Magic, thank you.
At the entrance to the park, two very important people are having to take care of the traffic. I asked the girls about working on the bank holiday.
Love it, but very busy.
And what are you actually doing?
We're actually making sure that the disabled drivers can get to the top of the hall and everybody can enjoy the event.
Do you do it? I know it's a bank holiday today. Do you enjoy working on a bank holiday?
We work. The ranger service works 365 days a year, including Christmas Day. Yeah. Do we enjoy it? Yeah, we
do. You do?
Yeah.
They also need to check when the parade is on its way. What a beautiful day. Little did we know that this was the sign of things to come this year. As the parade approached, the park was in full flow with families, including dogs, enjoying this lovely day.
Make that society for the many, not the few. Solidarity.
We did manage a word with Shadow Chancellor John McDonnell. But first, we asked our MP, Julie Cooper, on her thoughts.
Well, we're having a lovely day. The sun's shining. It's May Day, a Labour Day. We're delighted to have John here. It will undoubtedly inspire Labour support and reach out to wider Burnley because our policies are decent ones.
This is our traditional May Day march procession and there'll be a rally now. Beautiful Burnley weather. Every year we do this and this May Day rally is one of the longest in the country, which has gone on. It's a celebration, basically, the trade union labour movement. We'll be hearing speeches about, yeah, the history of the movement, but also with the current struggles, what's happening in terms of individual campaigns by trade unions, and also the Labour Party's campaign to go back in the government.
What about the young folk in Burnley?
There's a large number of young folk who have joined us this year, and there's been a resurgence in young people activity in politics. Labour Party now has 550,000 members, and a lot of those are young people, so it's a real breakthrough of this last year.
Once again, the month of May brings a change of mayors to our area, and on the 16th, Burnley Town Hall was preparing to greet councillors and other dignitaries for this prestigious event. As usual, the floral displays at the top of the stairs was at its best. Our new mayor, Councillor Charlie Briggs, arrives, along with partner and mayoress, Patricia Lunt. Feeling a little nervous, I suspect.
Members of the council, ladies and gentlemen, will you please be upstanding to receive first of all the mayor of the council, Mr. Howard Jacobs. Thank you.
Councillor Charlie Briggs as mayor. I call upon Councillor Jeff Sumner to move the election of Councillor Charlie Briggs as mayor of the borough and chair of the council for the ensuing municipal year.
Mayor Howard Baker called upon the council to move the election of Councillor Briggs.
Thank you.
After a short recess, the new mayor was presented to the chamber. Mayor Briggs then gave a very informative acceptance speech. And after other various speeches, the party moved to the mechanics for refreshments. We asked Roger Frost how he thought the mayor making went.
It's very well organised, the mayoral ceremony in Burnley. I've been to other places, which is nowhere near as well organised as Burnley. But David Farrer, who is the mayor's officer, organises things very well.
We asked now ex-mayor Howard Baker if he'd enjoyed his year in office.
Absolutely brilliant. It's been really, really good. I can't think of... Nothing went bad, nothing went wrong. I didn't upset too many people, which was my big worry all the way along. But no, it was absolutely fantastic. We've enjoyed every minute. And we're just saying today, we cannot believe that the year's passed so quickly. It's been really, really good.
Our reporter, Albia Begum, asked our new mayor how his day went.
How was the day today?
It's been a bit of two halves. This morning, I was very, very calm up to when I was reading my speech, and then anxiety got in and I nearly panicked. So, yeah, it's been a good day.
The following day, down the road in Nelson, a similar ceremony was taking place. Pendle Mayor David Wally was handing over the chains to the new first citizen, James Keith Starkey, at Nelson Town Hall. A much more relaxed affair, but by no means less important. The outgoing mayor and mayoress, councillors David and Barbara Wally, arriving. It was then time for the business of the day.
Councillors, ladies and gentlemen, please give a hand in the worship of Pendle, Councillor David Moreland. Enthusiasm and professionalism. And
an organisation that you meet across.
Yes, now, Albert.
After council moving for the installation of the new mayor of Pendle, Councillor Whalley then took his place in the chamber next to his wife. Councillor James Keith Starkey then took his place as the new mayor of Pendle.
I, James Keith Starkey, having been elected to the office of mayor, declare that I take that office upon myself and will duly and faithfully fulfil the duties of it according to the best of my judgment and ability.
And on the 22nd of May, our two local mayors came together with other mayors and dignitaries of the region, along with the public, and another unique event, the Mayor at Home, whereupon Burnley opens its doors to a lovely social gathering with afternoon tea and informal chats. Ladies of the Mayor's Committee are running the usual tombola. All monies from today's event, including the raffle, of course go to charity.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand to observe a minute's silence for the Manchester bombing victims. Thank you.
Ah yes, time for the raffle. Ladies and gentlemen,
thank you. The Mayor and Mayoress can now draw the raffle. If you winner, please put your hand up and one of the ladies' committee will bring the prize to you. Thank you. And it's 410.
8, 8, 8. I asked Mayor Starkey what he was looking forward to during his year in office.
I think that hopefully spreading the good word for Pendle and of Pendle, that's very important. And putting on a good show on behalf of the lovely people of Pendle, and visiting obviously not only places within Pendle, but like today coming out over the border into Burnley. Now that's a very big, a big ask, is that, coming into Burnley. We had to have the blacked out windows,
The new Mayor of Burnley certainly enjoyed the day's event.
It's been fantastic. I've really enjoyed it. It's been the best day I've had for a long, long while with everybody being here, especially the guests for the top tables. They've all been fantastic and I can't wait to meet them all again.
So are you looking forward to your year in
office? Oh yes, I am. I'm very proud to be the Mayor of Burnley and hopefully we can carry it forward and make a really, really good year.
I'm sure you will.
The picturesque St John's Church in Higham on Sunday, May the 27th, was the venue for our Pendle Mayor's Mayoral Sunday, attended by family and friends along with many local dignitaries. The service was held by the Mayor's chaplain, Reverend John Hallows, former Vicar of St Mary's New Church and now Vicar of St Mary's Gisborne, and also the Reverend Jane Berry, who is the Vicar of Higham St John's and also Vicar of St Anne's Fence. These vicars seem to do an awful lot of multitasking. Reverend Berry welcomes everyone to this special occasion.
Good morning, everyone. We do welcome you all to St John's Parish Church here in Higham for this celebration service.
At the centre of this village is a pub which rejoices in an unusual name, Four Alls. And I'm going to give you a little test Put your hands up if you know what the four rules are. Well done, Mr. Mayor. Well done, Mr. MP. A bit hesitant there. Well, you should be ashamed of yourself. If you live in Higham, you should know that the four rules are: the king rules for all, the priest prays for all, the soldier fights for all, but the ordinary man or woman pays for all.
Wayne, thank you for coming.
After a lovely service, the congregation, led by Nelson's brass band, slowly made their way down to a very appropriate small garden opposite the Four Alls pub, where there was a final word and prayer from the Mayor's chaplain. We then asked the Mayor how he'd enjoyed the day.
I thought it was wonderful. Everybody thought that it was a lovely service, which I think it was. The vicar had picked the hymns, so that worked well. It was lovely to see local villagers, friends, family. We've just been down to look at my grandmother's grave, and it was just a joyous time, fabulous. Weather was good, good band, couldn't ask for more. So what I've learnt as a councillor, I think the one thing I'd like to pass on is just to be kind to people. I think the words that the vicar spoke in church were lovely. So that was, and I hope that people heard that. And whoever we are in public life, we're all working really for the same thing. So that was a nice touch within church.
Thank you very much, sir.
You're welcome. Lovely. Always nice to see you. Lovely.
We interrupt your viewing for a moment to pay respects to Mayor Starkey's chaplain, the Reverend John Hallows. Not long after filming this wonderful event, he sadly passed away. The Reverend Hallows had been Vicar of Barrow Ford and New Church in Pendle until his retirement in 2016. Since that time, he has been part-time Vicar of Gisburn.
Shoppers who'd been waiting for the new Primark store to open its doors this year were finally rewarded on the 18th of May. What a beautiful day! What a beautiful day for running into Next and shouting, "Did you know there's a Primark opening next door?"
Debbie, where have you come from today?
From Manchester.
All the way from Manchester.
Yeah. First in line was Debbie Robinson, who'd travelled from Manchester back to her hometown for the opening.
Very massive fan. I shop every day in Primark.
We did manage a word with the leader of Burnley Council, but first we spoke to our new mayor. This being one of his first public appointments.
Everybody been there.
And how are you feeling about today?
A little bit excited. You know, it's a proud moment to get Primark here. Yeah, so I'm very happy. Yeah.
And are you looking forward to your future?
Oh yeah. I'm really looking forward to it. And I just want to make sure that this town gets brought back, and I want to add a little bit of humour to it as well, you know. So
I'm extremely excited about today's event. It's been a long time in the coming. We've been trying to get Primark here for 10 years, and now they're actually here. It's generated a great deal of excitement in the town. I'm excited, and I think it'll basically be fantastic news for the town going forward.
I was also very lucky to bump into Gary Orioff, a very famous fashion guru.
Who are you?
Hi, I'm from Fashion TV, and it's just wonderful to talk to these beautiful people up and down this wonderful, what I would call it, a queue, essentially. And it's just to find out what the great fashion tips are from the good people here in Burnley. So here we are. Well, welcome everyone. We're here in Burnley with this massive queue of people. Let's have a cheer, everyone. Come on. And that's it. It's a wonderful. So word has it they're going to get 5% on. If they get here early, so it's exciting. I'm joking.
Excuse me, is this the new Primark?
Not sure what this chap's famous for.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Burnley Primark store was open. And what an atmosphere. Another victory in the boosting of our town.
May 27th, Pendle Power Fest at Nelson and Colne College. A bouncy castle for the young. And a group for the teenagers. A young boy driving a racing car. Trophies on display. Many cars are on show at this Power Fest. Book a practice flight on a glider from Chipping for £60. Stormtroopers.
L is for the way you look out of me.
A birds of prey display. Bull riding. A few more cars. A trike with two wheels at the front and one at the rear. Motorcycle for delivering blood.
The former Princess Royal pub, which is a stone's throw from Turf Moor, is where claret fans used to get refreshed before a match. Landlady Justine Lorriman, a season ticket holder at Turf Moor, made a promise back in November last year that if the Clarets, who had just moved into fourth spot in the Premier League, managed to land European football, she would rename the pub to the Royal Deitch, after the Clarets manager, Sean Deitch.
We'd recently offered him free drinks when we achieved Premier League survival, so we thought we'd go on better, so yeah, name the pub after him.
After a great season, Burnley made it to 7th in the league, with 54 points, so we're in the Europa League, albeit not for too long. Burnley's number one fan, Rocky, has followed the Clarets all his life, is now being interviewed by Sky Television.
Just how good a manager is Sean Deitch. I mean, you say he should be the next England boss, but yeah. You want to keep bothering
him. Please, you don't know me, my name's Justine. I'm the landlady of what is now the Royal Deitch. Just going to hand over to the main man, Rocky. I just want to thank you all for being here. Thank you to everybody for supporting us. This is actually our 5-year anniversary today. We've had this club for 5 years, so just thank you for everybody's support as well over the past 5 years. So I'm just going to hand over to the main man, Rocky. I'm going to let him reveal the sign, what everybody's been waiting for.
Rocky, 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 Roc
the 1st of June 2018, the Princess Royal became the Royal Deitch. The Brass in the Park event is always an enjoyable occasion.
Good afternoon. Oh, it's a bit loud, isn't it? I woke you all up though, didn't I? good afternoon. We are East Lancs Concert Band. We've come all the way from Oswaldwistle. This is one of our regular spots each year. Luckily this year we've got...
It takes place each year in various parks in the Burnley area. All concerts run between 2 and 4pm and are free of charge. They are organised by Burnley Council with support from the park's friends groups. This year the event was launched on the 3rd of May with the East Lancashire Concert Band performing in the bandstand in Paddyham Memorial Park.
And how long will it take you to get this picture finished?
It depends. Sometimes I have a little fight on my hands and it'll take me longer than I wanted, or sometimes it could be like four to six hours and I might have a finished painting then, but sometimes it can take days. I'll scrape it back and sort of keep painting until I'm... Yeah, that's how long it'll take, until I'm happy with it. Until I'm happy that I can say, I'll put my knife down now and sort of conclude it, you know.
So you paint with palette knife, not a brush.
Arts and crafts, so
there you go.
What we've been doing recently is taking photographs and then we're embroidering in the photographs, and that's what the exhibition's going to be.
I wonder how close that can get into.
It's sort of traditional crafts but with a twist. It's probably the best way to describe it. But it's free for anyone to come along and everything we do is free. And there's free tea and coffee.
June the 14th was the date that a very important new facility was officially opened at Pendleside Hospice on Reedley Road. Radio 5 Live presenter Tony Livesey was the guest of honour, opening this new dedicated space for support of families and carers. The building, based in the grounds of the former Reedley Hall, just inside the entrance to the hall and hospice, was recently acquired by the hospice.
So I just want to say a huge warm welcome to everybody that's come to the opening of our family centre. We're delighted to have acquired this building to give us some dedicated space for families and carers to receive one-to-one and group support and counselling, really providing a safe haven for people who need our support. So,
right, hello everybody. I don't normally do things like this, but I didn't hesitate to come here today because this absolutely resonates with my personal circumstances. I was brought up in Nelson, and my mum died when I was 13, so that was 1977, and I was back at school within a week. There was no real grieving process.
Tony Livesey speaks out about bereavement.
At the time, I wasn't even told she had cancer, so she just died one Friday night, and that was that.
Yeah.
Right. Where are we? Are we okay?
Yeah.
Here we go.
And what we're trying to do is provide a facility for children who've been bereaved, so they can come and talk to trained counsellors, because when a child loses a parent, it's a really difficult time for them, and the facilities elsewhere, they're very difficult to hold of. And we've been chatting to some of the children in the centre this morning, and I think it's a really great facility. It's really helped them, and it's enabled them to cope a little bit better with what's going on in their lives at a really difficult time.
Yeah, I think it's a fantastic facility. I suppose I should be shocked in a way that it hasn't emerged before, really, because I have my issues with my mother dying 40 odd years ago when I was 13. There was no counselling then, there was no real support for children. And it's amazing what they're doing. It's amazing that finally the investment has come for it to happen. And it's amazing that a generation of children won't have to go through what I went through, which was basically, through ignorance really more than anything else, but it was kind of get up and get on with it. And that doesn't work for a child who's lost a parent.
No, it doesn't.
The 16th of June saw Burnley College open its doors to the public with a wonderful festival of science and technology. Tutors and students were showing many interesting and fascinating displays involving modern science, with many activities to get involved in, not least Titan the Robot. Robot. I spoke to the college principal about the event.
So what we've done is we've set up a science festival in Burnley because we're trying to raise aspirations of all the young people. So we're trying to get them excited about science because it's in every job that they do. So the more we can get them excited at a young age, the more that they'll get involved in it as they get older and get better paid jobs and other things like that. It's going really, really well. We've got more people here than we anticipated. As yet, we've had no rain. People are eating outside. We've got all the people that we wanted to come, and it feels spaced out, but it feels really nice.
Among many outside areas, the fire brigade were warning of chip pan fires and what not to do. Good lad. The wonderful display of projects certainly attracted plenty of attention from both young and not so young. Whatever the world is coming to, the day was a great success. Prosecco and wine, gin, vodka, lager and beer were the special guests at the Mayor of Pendle's garden party on the 1st of July this year. The event was held in the beautiful village of Roughlee as part of the Mayoress's charity fundraising. The venue for this prestigious occasion was the Roughlee Village Centre. And it was hosted, of course, by the Mayoress of Pendle, Janet Starkey. Many dignitaries and mayors were guests at this Buckingham Palace style afternoon tea.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good morning.
Hello.
The entertainment was provided by the Red Rose Brass Band. Our mayoress is certainly planning on raising plenty of cash. The main table is certainly getting into the spirit of this glorious afternoon.
Sorry, proceed about. What?
We've left the chain at home.
Got Pendle chains at 1:10, and then at 4:00 we've got, for the first time ever, probably.
It depends on how free that is.
Look, these poor lads in the third division, they've got...
It was just about then that the Red Rose Band made their entrance.
Honoured guests in the corner, mayors from across Lancashire.
It was then time for food. The weather was certainly on its best behaviour, and of course, we didn't know at this time that this was the beginning of a wonderful warm summer.
Today has been wonderful. It was always part of my plan to have an outdoor event in this wonderful place. We've been involved with the village centre for 20 years in Roughlee, and when we had to stand down to become mayor, one thing I asked the excellent committee was, would they mind hosting an event like this? And obviously never would we have imagined that the good Lord would give us so much sunshine. Not obviously for today, but the last 4 or 5 weeks. So it's everything I wanted it to be, really. And I think that everybody is just thoroughly enjoying themselves and having a nice time.
On the 7th of July, the Mount Zion Church at Cliviger opened its new extension to form a lift and community space. The aim of the new extension was to provide access for the disabled and to help those struggling with the steps leading up to the church. It also created a room for use by the church and for local community groups. The project was given the go-ahead in 2015 and construction of the extension started in 2017. Many benefactors from within and outside the chapel all contributed with donations to the project, which cost over £200,000. It's now time for the opening ceremony to get underway, and there was quite a good turnout for the event.
So welcome to our opening ceremony and to our inclusive access community space. It sounds like a big mouthful, that. But that's what it is, and we're pleased to be here now on this opening day. It seems a long time coming, a long time in the planning, but today's the day when we realise all our vision. For those who don't know me, my name's Alan Scholes, and it's my privilege to welcome here this afternoon our Member of Parliament, Julie Cooper, and our newly inaugurated Mayor, Charlie Briggs. So it's lovely to have them along with us this afternoon.
We now regard this facility as God's gift to our village.
Long-serving member of the church, Colin Scholes, was chosen to open the new extension.
It's for you.
Yay!
Once the extension was officially opened, the building was open for people to view it. The new lift was also in operation. The event was a great success and it provided a great opportunity to bring the whole community of Cliviger together to celebrate a new use for the church.
Burnley most certainly made the most of our wonderful summer. July the 14th, and it was another hot day, perfect for Burnley's summer garden party. The food stalls were getting ready for a busy day. Our town had everything to put the smile on the face of shoppers, and of course those who had gone to have a look at what this Burnley party was all about. Fancy a spot of Tai Chi? There were many stalls with everything you could wish for to browse or buy, of course. And these people are the Sky Band from West Yorkshire, reputed to be the best street band ever. And in complete contrast, these boys were creating a more contemporary sound. The day again was a great success.
I'm very proud. I couldn't believe it when I was approached by the club and for permission to have a stand named after me. I consider this one of the highest honours any player can earn in the game.
Jimmy signed for Burnley in 1950 and served them majestically for 13 years.
This is one of the finest moments I've had since I came to Burnley over 60 years ago.
On the 20th of August this year, our town lost its greatest ever footballer, Jimmy McIlroy. Jimmy McIlroy passed away on August 20th, 2018. His funeral took place on Friday, August the 31st.
Yeah, well, I knew Jim Mack from the first week he came here. And initially, I used to sell programmes. And what I used to do was get to the ground early, get my collection of programmes, and go and stand under the culvert. So I got rid of them in good time before the match started. So then you came back to the office. You got paid your little bit of commission, but you then went in the enclosure to watch the match. And that's, in the 50s, 1950s.
The sad passing of Burnley's adopted son, Jimmy McIlroy.
just from the moment I arrived, as I said, I felt at home, and it was the people here who made me feel at home. And this is and has been home for over 50 years now.
The work is almost completed on Pendle Hill's new path project.
So we've got rid of the big scarf, which you can see now, and the route zigzags, meanders up the hillside. We're just going to change that last bit because we feel it's just a little bit steep. So we'll grade that in tomorrow and make that a lot easier for you, your walkers.
Part of the £2.4 million project, partly funded by the National Lottery, will include repairing and laying of new paths and building a stone shelter for walkers. What's your opinion of the new Pendle Hill project, the path project?
Vast improvement and shelter for when it gets a bit bad, because people still come up here wearing flip-flops and plimsolls. And also when the cloud comes down and the visibility goes, you've got a path that you can follow, so it's taking you somewhere rather than trying to walk over the moss.
Been told that these paths are all new and we think they've made a really good job of it.
We've got Meet You at the Top today, and it's all a big event to get people from Downham all the way up to the top of the hill, or getting people from Barley walking all the way to the top of the hill, where we've got about 10 questions and they're going to have to find the missing word. The missing words are actually written on rocks, which Jane is handing out now. So each volunteer who's going to be placed all along the trail is going to have a rock with an answer on. So hopefully everyone will find all 10 of them and they'll meet us at the trig point at the top.
There's a lot of us, including a bit of guidance from the Mountain Rescue, going to walk up Pendle Hill. The Mayor of Pendle, Mayor Starkey, is setting off from Barley. We're here in Downham. We're going to march up. Some of us who can't walk so far because of operations recently are going to go in vehicles.
Excellent.
But most of them are going to go and enjoy a good stroll up this wonderful Pendle Hill.
We will be walking you up the hill, but you will need to find your own way down.
The mayor from the Ribble Valley joined Pendle's mayor, James Starkey, for the usual photo call. The sun came out just as the walkers were reaching the summit. Both mayors were taken to the summit in suitable all-terrain vehicles. Pendle Hill Landscape Partnership volunteers marshalled the routes to ensure people found their way safely to the top. The organisers were delighted that so many people, well over 200, made the effort to meet at the summit for this special occasion.
I'd like to welcome people to the summit of Pendle Hill, 1,831 feet above sea level. I'd like to welcome the mayor of Ribble Valley, whose ward, no, not your ward, but your patch starts just about there.
Yeah, and I'd like to say thank you very much to the mayor of Pendle for inviting everybody to walk up from his borough to see mine.
This is me, just to prove to the wife where I was.
We here at Burnley Film Makers do our very best each year to produce a newsreel that is both informative and entertaining. More importantly, it creates a true record of our town's history, a copy of which is sent to the Northwest Film Archive. Bearing all that in mind, we truly hope that you've enjoyed our presentation this evening. So thank you for your support, and not least the support of the local dignitaries. And of course, have a safe journey home.